this is my front garden. The interesting thing about this is everything in here is edible. So it's really easy when you plant like that, that you know, the kids can play and taste and eat anything. This is oregano, so look at it. Just from this tiny front garden, when I cut all this down at the base, tie it up and dry it, right, there's enough oregano there for barbacoa 15 and my house for the whole year. Come see my little boy, he's so cute. He's just like, oh, he's just too much. I can't handle him. He's probably dressed up in some crazy outfit. He changes about 8 times a day. Hi.
Hello.
I'm just talking to Ashley about, hi pets. I'm just talking to Ashley about herbs. Do you want to say anything about herbs? What do you know about herbs? Show him where the bubble gum is. The stuff you chew on. So do you remember what this is called?
Fennel.
What?
Fennel.
Yeah. Now show me how you strip it off and roll it in a ball.
Okay.
So you pull it off, roll it up into his hands. Right, show him how tight it is before you put it in your mouth. This is what the Romans did when they were marching. Because before the Romans came to Britain, we were eating cabbage and nothing much else was going on really. But thank God for the Romans. So they stole and pillaged every single village in the country, but that's worth it. So these fennel, show them what you do with it now, buds. So you bash it in your mouth and you start to chew it. Now you don't eat it, you just chew it. And what happens is your spit in your mouth goes with all the natural sweetness in the fennel and you just go and you get the most delicious bubble gum. It's like bubble gum, isn't it, dude? Mm-hmm. And then after about 2 minutes, his face will go from pleasure. Look at the pleasure. Look at the pleasure in his face. Right? And then it will start being like you've got a load of old weeds in your mouth, and then you just spit it out. But they used to use fennel like a thirst quencher. It's delicious. Fennel is a massive digestive, settles the stomach,
yeah,
cleans your palate, makes your breath smell good. These are beautiful. And these guys, these just pick off these little buds here. These buds are like they're like little sweets.
Buds, buds.
Yeah, his name's Buddy.
Can I eat this?
Which one? And also notice that, like, notice that he asked if he could eat it. Like buds, you can eat that one. They're quite crunchy and sweet. Roasting chicken or fish with this or pork is unbelievable. But also teaching the kids to say, "Can I eat this?" You know, because you can't just eat anything. That is like a Tic Tac, isn't it?
It is, but it doesn't look like one.
Don't look like one. These things are they're perennial, so they come back every year. They cost nothing to plant. Like you can plant them in abundance around your kitchen, window boxes, the whole lot. People suffer from window boxes. Just change the soil every year. Okay, it runs out of energy. But they just grow. They're weeds, man. And there's nothing better than like just grabbing stuff out the window. Look at George's face, she thinks I'm so boring. She's put up with this. How long have you put up with this?
30 years.
Right, don't exaggerate. Since I was 18, 22 years. 30 years. When I'm picking herbs for like cooking for lunch or dinner, she's lurking on the computer. I start like twerking and like doing rude gestures. And I try and make her laugh while she's having her lesson. So I think that translates as being terrible dad. I think I'm a really cool dad, but my kids think I'm a really boring dad. So
they'll learn.
Yeah, I got no street cred at all.
You got 17 books though.
I have got 17 books, but that doesn't get you street cred with teenagers.